Hi all, today we are going to discuss about electric dipole, a system of two equal and opposite point charges separated by a small distance is said to form an electric dipole. Let us take for example, I am taking two charges. So one charge I am taking as minus Q, another charge is plus Q. Let us assume the distance between them is very small. That means they are separated by very small distance when compared to any other distance which you are taking in your numerical. So then we can tell that it is forming a dipole. So this is called as a dipole. Generally the dipole is specified by the dipole moment. So dipole moment is a vector quantity. Always the dipole moment is mentioned from the negative charge to the positive charge. This will be the direction of the dipole moment, and this dipole moment is given by capital P. So this dipole moment is nothing but the product of the charge, that means any charge on either plus Q or minus Q, this charge multiplied by the distance separating between them. This is multiplied by Q into S. So we can write the dipole moment as P is equal to Q multiplied by S. So the units will be Q is in coulombs and S is the separation between them. Let us assume we are representing in meters. This will be given in coulomb meter. Let us see what will be the effect of this dipole on the value of potential or electric field intensity at a particular point. So for that, to analyze this properly, so I am just assuming that my charges are lying along the z-axis. So one charge is lying here, another charge is lying here. Let us take it as plus Q. Let us take the second charge as minus Q. Let us assume I am taking a point P. This P is at location r comma theta. It is at location r comma theta. Let us assume it is making a distance of, this distance is equal to r1. Similarly, this second charge is making a distance of r2, or with respect to the center, let us assume this is 0. With respect to this, it is at some distance in the positive z axis and this is in the negative z axis. So we can tell that this gap is equal to L. So let us assume this angle that is subtended here is equal to theta 1. Similarly, this angle subtended here is theta 2. Now from the center, I am drawing one line. That line is also pointing towards this point. So let us take the radius of this line is equal to r. So now from this point, I can draw a perpendicular like this. So when you draw a perpendicular, so let us assume this angle is equal to theta. So if you want to calculate this perpendicular will be, this same length is projected here. So if you want to calculate this, so because this distance is s by 2, this distance is also s by 2. So now, if you want to calculate the potential at point P, because potential at this point P, I can calculate by Q by 4 pi epsilon multiplied by 1 by R1. This is due to positive charge, and due to second charge, that is negative charge, it will be attractive force. So I can write as Q divided by 4 pi epsilon into 1 divided by R2, or otherwise this I can write as Q by 4 pi epsilon into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. This is what we got. Let us take it as equation number 1. So now, as the P is very far, the dipole moment, we can just assume the angle subtended theta 1 is equal to theta 2 is equal to theta, because the value of S is far, far less than the value of the radius or the distance we are taking. So that's why the angle difference will be very less. So we can write the value of this R1 and R2. I can write my value of R1 is equal to this R minus S by 2 into cos theta. R minus S by 2 into cos theta. If you are taking the cos theta, it will be projected in that direction, because this will come here. This will be cos theta, because this is S by 2, you are projecting in this direction. So we can write that small r is equal to capital R1 plus S by 2 cos theta, or R1 is equal to small r minus S by 2 cos theta. Similarly, I can write my value of R2. R2 means I can get by projecting like this. So this is nothing but R plus S by 2 cos theta, because this extra thing, this comes is S by 2 cos theta 2. In this case, we are assuming that theta 2 is equal to theta 1 is equal to theta. It becomes S by 2 cos theta. Let us take it as equation number 2. Let us try to further simplify. Now, substituting equation number 2 in equation number 1, we can write the value of the voltage will be equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon into 1 divided by R minus S by 2 cos theta, this is one term, minus 1 divided by R plus S by 2 cos theta, this is the second term. So we can simplify this one. So this becomes Q by 4 pi epsilon into, so this will become S cos theta divided by, denominator will be R square minus 0.25 into s square cos square theta. This is what we get. So this I can write as, because this q multiplied by s we have already defined by the term p, so I am writing the magnitude of the p into cos theta divided by, this will become 4 pi epsilon into r square minus 0.25 s square cos square theta. So let us take it as equation number 3. So we know the value of this radius r is already so much greater than the value of s, and if you are taking r square, this r square will be far far greater than 0.25 times of s square cos square theta, because s is very small compared to the radius. So we can simplify this as equation as, this will become p cos theta divided by 4 pi epsilon into r square, or this I can write as the dipole moment taking the dot product with ar, that means unit vector in the direction of r, because the angle between the dipole moment and the vector r, you can see here the dipole moment and vector r is this angle is equal to theta. So it will give the cos theta divided by 4 pi epsilon r square. So this is the potential at any point. So now from this equation we can observe that this potential due to dipole is proportional to cos theta divided by r square, but we have seen in our previous classes the potential due to point charge, the potential due to point charge is inversely proportional to r, because q by 4 pi epsilon naught r, that is what we get. So here you can see here it is inversely proportional to r square, or we can tell that for the case of dipole moment, as the distance is changing, the decrease in the value of v, that means v will degrade at a much more faster rate when compared to due to the point charge. That is what the observation we are making from here. And for a specific value of the potential function, let us assume that the value of v is equal to v naught at some particular point. Using that, we can, using this equation number 4, we can calculate the value of cos theta. So cos theta is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught v naught divided by p into r square. So let us take it as equation number 5. So now for a given medium, so we can tell that this entire thing, all these elements are constant for a given potential. So cos theta is directly proportional to r square. So this I can write in the form some constant k multiplied by r square. So that means cos theta is proportional to r square. So if you are drawing the lines, let us assume a dipole moment is there. Dipole moment I am representing by the arrow. So the potential due to this at any point, so potential is maintained constant. So as the angle of theta is varying from with respect to this, with respect to this point, so automatically the magnitude is changing. So if you plot the graph, you will get your graph like this. This will be the plot for different values of the voltages. So it will come like this. So same thing is the case in the second side also. Like this you will get. So this is for 1, this is for potential of 2, this is for potential of 3. As the potential is increasing, the value of k increases, so automatically k multiplied by r square, that will increase as the theta is changing. Similarly, this side, this will be for negative potentials, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. So, and this will be for k is equal to 0, so automatically this value will be equal to 0. So, this way the field distribution or the field lines will come. That field lines we have seen in the case of isolated charge, it is different, but here it is not like that. So at some point they are touching each other, they are starting from a single point. So this way the field will distribute. Let us now see what will be the field intensity. So we can calculate the field intensity is equal to negative gradient of V in spherical coordinates. So in spherical coordinates we can calculate the value of ER is equal to minus dou V by dou R. So this you calculate dou v by dou r, because we know the potential. So this will become p cos theta divided by 2 pi epsilon into r cube. This is what we get. Similarly, if you are taking with respect to theta, 1 by r into dou v by dou theta, this will become p sin theta divided by 4 pi epsilon into r cube. This is what we get. So similar is the case if you are calculating e phi, because there is no variable phi in the voltage equation. So this will be equal to 0. Let us take it as equation number 7. So from this equation, I can write my total value of electric field intensity at any point will be equal to P divided by 2 pi epsilon r cube into 2 cos theta in the direction of AR plus sin theta in the direction of A theta. So this is what we get. Let us take it as equation number 8. So from this equation we can observe that this electric field intensity is inversely proportional to R cube, whereas the electric field intensity due to point charge. So point charge we have written that it will be equal directly inversely proportional to R square. So here also you can observe that E decreases more rapidly when compared to the point charge as you are going away or the distance is increasing. So I am summarizing, both V and E decreases more rapidly with distance as compared to point charge. This is what we obtain. And one more thing I forget to tell you, I have already provided the link for the material in the link below. Please go to the description. You can, there is a Google Drive link there. You can download the complete handwritten material from there, as well as whatever I am writing on the screen, a snapshot of this also I have provided there. You can please download from there. Here you just try to understand what I am teaching. So remaining things you can download from there. So now I am taking one example, two dipole with dipole moments minus 5 times of Az nano coulomb meter and 9 Az nano coulomb meter are located at points 0, 0, -2 and 0, 0, -3 respectively. Find the potential at the origin. This is what is given in the question. Let us try to solve this. So to solve this, you can see two dipole moments are given. One is at point 0, 0, 2. If you write the x, y and z plane, this is 0, 0, 0 and 0, 0, -2. That means in the z axis, it is at -2. So this is x and y are 0, 0, -2. At this one dipole is there. So there is a dipole here. So there is one more dipole at 0, 0, z = 3. So at z is equal to 3, there is one dipole. Z is equal to -2, there is another dipole. I want to calculate what is the potential at the origin. So I have to calculate this. Remember this, this is x, y and this is z axis. Getting it? So how to calculate this one? So to calculate this, we already know V is equal to sigma, K is equal to 1, 2, because we have to take the summation of all because of all. So this will become dipole moment PK and multiplying with the unit vector, or unit vector in this direction, divided by 4 pi epsilon into RK square. This is what we get. Or this I can further simplify, K is equal to 1 to 2 PK divided by 4 pi epsilon naught RK square. And this unit vector I can write as the vector RK divided by its magnitude, the magnitude of RK. So this can be further simplified as K is equal to 1 to 2 PK dot RK divided by 4 pi epsilon into RK cube. In this way also you can write, or you can follow the first formula, any formula you can apply. So here in this example, it is given there P1 is equal to -5, it is in the direction of Az, and the P2 is given as 9 in the direction of Az, and the value of R1 is equal to 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0, -2. So this will become 2 times of Az. You have to take from negative charge to the positive charge. So the value of R1, or the magnitude of R1, so this R1 will be equal to 2. Similar way, I can calculate the distance R2 with respect to the center will be 0, 0, 0, because you are taking the final point is center, minus 0, 0, 3. It is the location of the dipole. So this will become 3 times of Az. So from this I can calculate my value of R2 will be equal to 3. Magnitude is coming as 3. It will be in the direction of this. So now we can calculate the value of the potential will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into, so if you substitute this will become, this will be 5 dot RK. So this will become -5 into 2, because both are in the z direction, divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. 4 pi epsilon naught we have written in the down, multiplied by RK cube. So this will become 3 cube. Minus, so similar is the case, so second one is coming 9 multiplied by 3 divided by 3 cube. This is what we get. So this I can write as, if you simplify this, this will become 20.25 into 10 to the power of 9 volts. So 20.25 megavolts is coming. Not this 10 to the power of 9, right? Or 10 to the power of 9 volts is coming. I hope how to what is the electric dipole and how to calculate the potential due to the dipole as well as electric field due to the dipole is completely clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.